Ouais, so guys, what I would like to teach you today, something we have learned, but we just wish there was an easier way to learn it or to understand it. Today I'll be drawing some of our examples in the Pickup and Packer engineering drawing textbook. And I'll pick number 3 from the tangency problem examples. So with number 3, we have the instruction that the distance between our two circle is going to be 5. So we'll pick our point. So the first one should be here. The second one should be here. This is our point. What do we do? The radius of the first circle, 2.5. Second one, 1.2. You just have to be careful when you're drawing circles with very little radius. Now, the instruction given to us that the tangent coming from here to here will be with a radius of 40, and the arc tangent coming from here to here will be with a radius of 80. Now, we always assume their measurements are correct, and based on what has been taught to us previously, we have to do some plus and minus with the radius of the external arc just to be able to get what we are looking for perfectly. But most times it doesn't come out that way. But now we can just use our vision, and we are going to be using only our compass with no stress of having to calculate whatsoever. We just get the answer. So that's what I'm willing to teach today, and that's what I'll be teaching you today. So with this now, we have been told that the radius of the upper arc, the internal arc, will be radius of 4 centimeter. So let's get our 4 centimeter. Now, how do we do this? It's a very simple thing. Now, with our radius of 4 centimeter, all we need to do is to visualize where we are going to make the point meet on the circumference of these two circles. For here, from what I'm seeing here now, our point is probably going to start from here, and it's going to meet this at this place. Now, this is not a method of total accuracy, but it is a method of speed. And if it has been consistently worked on, we can have both the accuracy and the speed together. But with this, it is much more easier for us to go through our exams and our tests and whatever assignments that we have through this method. That is just the basic of it all. So with this, we have our tangent. Most times it might not be as easily gotten as this. Most times. So I would always advise that our arc lines should and must be very, very light, so that in case you make a sketch, just make a sketch on it like this and see if it actually touches the tangent, just as a practice for the practicing. Because when you get used to it, you'll be able to pick the right points and make the right arcs. So now to get the second arc, the external arc, we have a radius of 8. Just like I said before, it's not about accuracy. This method is not accuracy. We are just for something that will fasten us and still give us that much of accuracy. For your first few tries, You might not be accurate. You will not be accurate. I will not lie to you. You will get it wrong. But you just have to keep trying. Practice makes perfect. So now is to visualize where I'm going to make my points to meet on this particular piece of work. And I have this. I want it to meet here. I mean, it's coming to meet here. I want this. Draw my arc. Where the arcs meet, I put my points, and voila. I take it through. And I have what I'm looking for. If I decide to darken this one, well, let's just go over it. Now, with this, I would like to try number one and number two, as well as number four, just so we can understand this very well. But very quickly, I want you to move very fast with me. Now, let's get ourselves another horizontal line. Right, and with this, they said the point the distance between the horizontal line is 65. So we have, let's measure our 65. 65. 65. Now, with that number one question, this will be number one question. This is number three. The number one question, we are told, okay, we are only working with a point and a circle. So we have a tangent to meet the point with the circle. Now, with the radius of two, we are going to draw the circle according to what we have there. The radius of two. I don't know. I would like you to actually go along with me if you can decide to get something to work with so you can understand and you can pick these lines very well. No problem. Okay, there's a twist here. Oh, yeah. So, with this particular one, our point is not actually here. It is to the tangent of this particular, if you are going to get it's our test score. That and then we have our horizontal line and we have our vertical line. And with our vertical line, we measure the distance of 65. Now we have to join this point to now. What do we do with the radius of 5 centimeter? 5 centimeter. Where do we want the points to meet? I visualize here. I'll reach my point. Now, let's join them together and see what we have. Do we see? So, if I decide to darken this, just to bring that the shape of the drawing. I'll have something like this. Let's see. This we are looking for. Pitch on the bottom. Again, in our horizontal line. Right. So the distance, okay, like I did before. Same thing, we're joining the points to a circle, but with this, there will be a lot of twists and thereabouts. Voila, voila, voila. Yeah. Can you imagine? Alright, no problem. Great point. Now, what do you say with the radius of 12? Like, I'm sorry, this is looking like this. Well, I didn't really practice this question. Like, I just came forward to present myself. Ah, no shit, man. It was still fun. Like, I'm just teaching this day, so I used to say free from anytime, any day. So, we have a radius of. Radius of 1.2. Then you get the tangent of this radius. According to what we need, get the tangent to the radius. Now, from this, we say we should measure a point, which is 4.4 centimeter away. 4 centimeter away. Now, what do we do? With the radius of 12, we have been asked where these two lines meet. Okay. Radius of 12 again. Well, see, this one is like having to draw 12 here, 12, but they only need this part of this side, too. Now, the next thing they asked us for to get an external arc of radius 35 if you draw out this. So, basically, what I'm just trying to teach you here is how to get this done without having to overstress yourself. I don't know if you understand it, but so the external arc of you should know that when our arc is coming from here, external, it has to come down. So, we'll be marking our points down here. And then, so where the points meet. So the radius of 3.5 to get our external, so we pick a point. Then we pick another point from here. Where the 2 points meet? We use that to draw the tangent, which is going to give us what we are looking for. So, basically, just roughing it through. So, if this was an example, an assignment like this, I'm done with 3 questions. I hope this video has helped you. And if you wish for me to continue, just hit me up. Let me know if this video really helped you. And if you want more, me to explain with further videos. Let me know. I want to be able to draw most of these. Okay, let's do number 8 real quick. Let's do number 8 real quick, please. Number 8. So with number 8, we have an horizontal line. Now from our horizontal line, we have a radius, the diameter of 32. So our radius is going to be 16. Radius 16. And an external radius is 25 because the diameter is 50, so the radius is going to be 25. Now, assessing that, so we have an horizontal line which we have to use our assessment to draw. So, be fast and so, draw horizontal line down. From the horizontal line, we are going to draw a vertical line where it meets 60. 6 centimeter. Have again another horizontal line. All right. So the distance between this is 3.2. Away. 3.2 away, and this is 4 away. Now from this point, we'll be having. I don't know what it was. Okay, with 2 buses as 25, that's 12. 12. So the bus circle will be 12. Sorry. Same as here, the bus circle will be 12 millimeter radius. Then the drill circle, that's 7.5. So that will be the drill circle. Right, drill circle. Now, we're going to join this guy as indicated with the steps I've been trying to teach you. I think this should be good enough. Now we'll start from this side. We said the radius of the external arc is 70. 70 millimeters. That's 7. That's 7. So, how do we do that? We want to join it here. We'll mark our arc. And we'll pick the point from here again. We'll mark our arc. So just like I said, when you go through, this is just to tell you how you can do the training. If I was to be in a more practical example, I would want to present a more practical work. So just Ah, de chaque langue. Dans la région de compte. So, even an example, those other erases will be counted as mistakes. They won't be counted as just errors. Won't be counted as much. Then the long will be radius of 105. 105. How do we do this? How do we do this? How do we do this? Then back to this. Think we had the parallel. Was the parallel? Yes. Yes. So we have a radius of 16.6. So practically, same thing. So let's get our things right. This is just wasting our work. So I'm deducting this now. Sorry, I have to just do this. I'm very sorry. So like, as you can see, I've never touched freehand sketching before. This is paramount to it, but not exactly what freehand sketching is all about.